Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to be walking you through a quick demonstration of using the authorization code grant with PKCE, which works great for applications of all types. So first off, the reason why we're starting with or showing the authorization code with PKCE is that first and foremost, it is the best choice for applications of all types. So whether you're using something like Ruby, Python, Node, etc., or you have a single page application or even a native mobile application, the authorization code with PKCE is the go-to choice for all of those different types of applications. One of the reasons why it's the kind of the best choice is that it is the most secure of all of the OpenID Connect grant types, primarily because it eliminates the need to use a client secret and instead uses something called a code verifier. And the other key reason is that it prevents the need to transmit the user credentials between your application, the client, and the identity provider. So user credentials are never transmitted between your app and the provider. The sample or the example that I'm going to be showing today is available as a sample on OneLogin's GitHub page. So you can either search OneLogin OIDC node, or you can also follow the link below or the URL below there to see this sample. So let's go ahead and jump in. So I've already got this up and running in a localhost development environment on my machine. And this is effectively just meant to simulate a custom application. So the way that the authorization code grant works is that you would have, you know, a login button on your website or application. And when the user clicks on this button, your application will then generate the OpenID Connect request, and then the user does get redirected to the identity provider. And so that's what we'll see in just a moment here. Now, I mentioned a second ago that with the authorization code grant, the credentials are never transmitted between the client and the identity provider, and that's why you get the redirect. There are other OIDC grant types which do not require the redirect, specifically, it's called the resource owner password grant. So that does not involve a redirect, but it does involve transmitting the credentials from your app or your site to the identity provider. So we'll have a separate video showing an example of that as well. So we'll go ahead and kick it off. So again, I'll click on the login button here. That's going to generate the OpenID Connect request and redirect me over here to OneLogin. Now, this is a OneLogin hosted login interface, and it's completely customizable. So things like the logo, the background image, the subdomain, or the entire domain, all customizable. Color scheme, things like this getting started link here, as well as the forgot password. These are all customizable. You can choose to exclude these if you want to. And you also have the ability to configure social providers. So things like Facebook, LinkedIn, Google, any provider that is OpenID compliant, or excuse me, OpenID Connect compliant, OAuth 2.0 compliant, or SAML 2.0 compliant can be included here as a identity provider. For this first example, I'm just gonna do kind of your traditional username and password, just to kind of show what the basic flow looks like, and I'll come back and do another example after that as well. So again, for this one, I'll just type in my credentials. And what's happening here is after I successfully authenticate, OneLogin actually is returning what's called the authorization code to the client, to the relying party, to the custom application. And then in a subsequent step, the relying party then exchanges that authorization code for the identity tokens or ID token and access tokens. Now, the ID token can contain any user information that you choose. So any of the information that's stored within the OneLogin directory can be included in the payload of that ID token. And if you're using OneLogin's API authorization capability, then the access token, which is returned, can be completely customized. So custom audience, custom scopes, custom claims, all possible to be returned in the actual JWT token, the JWT, which is returned back to your application. And a quick example of that is, you know, if I click on this profile option here, we can see some of the information that's being included in the ID token, so basic user info here. All right, so that's one example. Let's go ahead and do another quick example here. And this time I'm going to use a different user who's assigned to a different policy within OneLogin. And in this example, I'm going to be showing what a passwordless flow could look like. So OneLogin supports passwordless authentication in a variety of different ways. In this particular case, I'll be showing it with email magic link. But we also support a variety of different authenticators. So things like Google Authenticator, we have our own OneLogin Protect Authenticator and a corresponding SDK for that. And then also there's things like FIDO Web Authn. So if you wanted to use biometrics, you could do that as well. So let's go ahead and show the example again this time. Again, I'll just click login. Okay, redirects me over to OneLogin once again. And like I mentioned, I'm using a different user this time. Oops, demo. Okay, in this particular case, it's just gonna send me an email magic link. And so that's gonna get sent to my device. I'm just gonna open it up on my mobile off screen. And within that email, it's just gonna have a link inside, tells me click here. And then it gives me a success message and that completes the flow. So that's a really cool example of using a passwordless style authentication flow with email magic link. But again, you have a variety of different options for that as well. So hope you found this informative. If you have any questions, please reach out and thanks for watching.